Hello, hello everyone, and welcome to Laurence Plays for some Manhunt Checkpoint. And today we're doing something really weird. We've got the game set up so that whenever I get in a vehicle, all of the hunters will have whatever vehicle they're in changed to be an identical one. And if they ever try and change their vehicle, they'll be put back in a whatever I'm in. So I've picked an oracle because there's loads and loads of them spawning today, so that seems like a quite a good choice for that reason. And this is going to be a bit weird because it means the hunters are always going to know what model of vehicle I'm driving. So as soon as I get inside the circle, or as soon as, no, as soon as they get close, as soon as they find an oracle inside the circle, they're going to attack it because they're going to think it's probably me, which is why I've tried to pick something there's lots and lots of. So this is going to be tricky and hectic and probably difficult. Oh, and I've not changed clothes. I should do that. There we go, that'll do. That's another oracle. But also it means whenever I see any oracles, I'm going to get very, very paranoid. So this is going to be interesting. However, sitting here, even though it's obeying the traffic laws, is not going to be conducive to lasting very long, I don't think. Because, as I said, they're going to see an oracle and they're going to assume it's me. So I think I probably am going to be best off just sort of more or less keeping moving. But not absolutely. Not. I'm going to go for sort of a medium level of aggressiveness, should we say. So I'm going to drive at about the speed limit, but I'm not going to stop for traffic lights. And I'm hoping that will mean that when they. Oh, I'll stop for this one actually, because there's a hunter right behind me. Not anymore, there isn't. Okay, I can carry on. There's another hunter there. He's coming this way. Okay, let's pull a left turn here. So yeah, if they see me, they're going to get very, very suspicious because, as I said, they're just watching out for any oracles in the area. So I reckon I just need to. I'm best off if I just keep moving, even if that means gross abuse of traffic laws like that. And this does get me around a bit quicker. So maybe I should be playing like this more often. We'll see how that goes. But that's one checkpoint taken already, which is quite nice. So now let's try not to be in the area for very long, because I'm pretty sure that they're going to. I can't help feeling they're probably going to find me without too much difficulty. Now I can troll them a little bit by changing vehicles at inconvenient times, but working out what an inconvenient time is quite difficult, and also working out whether it's better to have a good car or a bad car, I don't really know, because. If I'm in a good car, they'll be in good cars as well because they'll be in identical vehicles. If I'm in a bad car, they'll have worse vehicles to use. Oh, been going the wrong direction. Damn it. Okay, so I now need to loop all the way back down round to the south side of the city. Let's go through here as fast as this little Premiere will take me and head down there. So I do have one or two cunning ideas that may or may not work. One of them is to go and try and take checkpoints on foot, because I think that's going to make it a little bit more confusing for them, because they will be fixating on the fact that I'm locked in the same vehicle as them. So if I head down there and switch to and then get out of the car and try and take a checkpoint on foot, it's going to. Yeah, going to give me a bit of a advantage by throwing them off. And if I can change to something absolutely terrible just before I first, then hopefully that'll make it harder for them to get to wherever I am. Now, I am almost down to the checkpoint now. There's one of the airport spaghetti checkpoint isn't very far from here. So I think, yeah, what if I jump into this? At least for a minute or two. I don't know. Do I want to just go over and try and take the checkpoint in this truck? I don't know. Either way, it's an amusing idea that I've now just dumped all of them straight into these trucks. So I haven't seen any hunters around for a bit, actually, which is quite interesting. Perhaps it's because I've been changing vehicles enough to and I've been driving because I've been driving a bit faster. They're not getting to the checkpoints quickly enough to really head me off. I think. I don't know. I'm sort of making this up as I go along, but I think just by sort of switching vehicles at unexpected times, well, any time is going to be relatively unexpected, although I've been ripping through them quite quickly recently. Let's stick with this truck at least until the next checkpoint appears, because that's going to make it harder for them to get down to find me wherever I am. And I'll just keep moving, just keep moving. Oh no, there's another truck coming up behind me. Oh no. They're catching up with me. Oh. Okay, we're going to have a truck chase, I think. Because I think that truck is probably, that other truck has probably seen me. Yes, it has. It's following me. Okay. Well, at least we're evenly matched, but I don't know whether I'm going to be able to realistically get away in this vehicle or not. We shall see how it goes. I am just going in a straight line at the moment, which is not the way to lose a tail. However, I'm not sure how well this truck is going to change directions. So I'm just going to keep going for now. Oh, it looks like they might have come a cropper, because they're not right behind me anymore. Oh no, there they are, I see them. So I think the escape strategy is going to be to pull a corner like this. Oh, I want to duck into an alleyway and then abandon the truck. That would be a good way to hide. Like this. Get out, get out, get out, get out. And then just start walking innocently along the road like this. Because they're going to expect me to still be in a truck. And presumably, any hunters around will also still be in trucks. Right, where am I trying to get to? Shopping centre jump. Alright, maybe, in hindsight, maybe I should have gone a bit further before I changed vehicles. There's a truck behind me there. I don't like this. Let's go up this road here and try and find something else to get into. Now, I could steal one of these cars. I think it's probably safe to reckon that they're not going to find me by spotting a broken window. They're going to find me by spotting vehicle models. That truck hasn't appeared, so I think I'm going to get in this Oracle. Hey, let's meet up next week. Yeah, there's no hunters around. Let's take the Oracle. Oh, there's a hunter. Watch it carefully. Pop! Did they see me? Did they see me? If they didn't, that was the luckiest getaway ever. Okay, so I need to get further up north in the city, which is not this way. I was heading south at that point. But I want to get a little bit away from the scene of the shenaniganery over there. So I'm going to head over this way now. I saw that truck and panicked, but no, it's Oracles I need to watch for now. Oh, this is ridiculous. Okay, so I need to get to Shopping Centre Jump or Origin. And I need to watch out for Oracles while I do so. I think the hunters are supposed to be recolouring the vehicles in... Yes, there we go, there's an orange Oracle. The hunters are recolouring their vehicles in their player colours. We decided a sort of a be sensible rule, so they don't have to change the colours instantly as soon as their vehicle changes, because if there was a chase going on or it's awkward for whatever reason, we don't want to make it things too difficult and to sort of ruin the game for them like that. But the idea is we've said that they are supposed to change vehicles as soon as reasonably sensible. So if they're not actually chasing me, they'll probably pull over, quickly change the colour, and then start moving again. Do I want to change vehicles again? Okay, I have a mic on my tail now. That was unfortunate. I don't know whether he was suspicious of me, but I sort of scraped him as he went past. Not deliberately, I have to say. But he spotted me and is now in hot pursuit. So now I need to get away from him and see if I can throw him off somehow and then make my way back over to the checkpoint. And this is going to be difficult. Oh dear, it's difficult if I drive like that. Yep, I was expecting that T-bone. And, ooh. That was weird. He hit me from one direction, then came in from a completely different direction. He must have just sort of spun around me in much the same way he spun me around. And then got me from there. So that was interesting. I wasn't expecting to be hit from quite that angle. I was expecting him to try and sort of follow up on it on the first impact with a second one. But I wasn't expecting him to come in from a random angle quite like that. All right. Now, how am I going to get away from him? This is, of course, entirely down to driving and skill at shenanigans at this point, because we are in... I was going to say we're in identical vehicles. Mine's taken a massive T-bone. His has taken a front impact, or two. I don't know which is worse for the cars. Oh, however, I'm not driving particularly well. Let's hope he isn't either. Oh. So he's going to have told them all that I'm in a grey Oracle, which is a little bit of extra information for them, because they only know the model. They don't know the colour of the vehicle I've changed into. So, yeah, if I can manage to change vehicles, then I'll have the advantage of being in an un... They won't know what colour I'm in, just what... Oh, damn it. I took my eyes off the road for 1 second, and there was a car in the way. And now there's three hunters on my tail. Four hunters on my tail. All four of them, very, very close. I don't know. I'm not sure what I'm trying to do. I've gained a bit of distance with that. I think they must have got tangled in each other on that corner, which is nice. We'll go through the checkpoint. I won't take it because I'm in a chase, and that's how we play the game. I'll just hoon all the way across the city. Now, we have got the option for turning the circle off enabled at the moment, so I can, should I feel the urge, I can turn the circle off to help me escape. So I'll do that now because I've got a little bit of distance off on them, and that means now I can hopefully pull a couple of corners here. I could do the dive into an alleyway again. That worked quite well last time. Let's try that. And round here. Did anyone see me do that? No, I think I've got away with that. Okay, right. Pedestrian time. Go, 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 go. Get a fucking prescription. Now the question is, did Mike identify my character model? So Tristan has spotted my old car. That's unfortunate. Oop. And I can't walk in a straight line. That's also unfortunate. So, Tristan is going to see the abandoned car and know that I'm around here on foot somewhere. And he knows that I'm on foot because he hasn't been put in a different car. Now, there's potential here for me to be extremely sneaky. If I can find another Oracle... That's a hunter. Okay. That's a worry. I couldn't recognise him because he's not in a... He's following me. I don't like this. My thought was, if I can switch into another Oracle... Ah! I was afraid he'd identified me somehow. I'm not sure how he did, but... Okay, that was interesting. I'm not sure it was good, but it was interesting.
I found an oracle that has two people in it.
Kill them both. I think I found an oracle. We changed car into a Premier.
So slow.
This one was janky, but it's not last 620.
You made me turn around to go and pursue or like help you out. I think it caused me a...
So he's going to
get out. Wow.
Is anyone up beyond south of Heliport?
I'm a bit north of it.
Head south of it, not taking the slip road thing. I think this is he's going through the checkpoint now or something. Assuming he's ahead of me on this road. Can't see it.
No catch and swim.
Mind the detail.
taken out.
Yes, I think I see him heading east towards Arena.
Alright.
There is one right in front of way in front of me. Is that you, Tristan?
I think probably. Is it purple?
Is someone going against traffic?
I've just gone from against traffic to with traffic.
Yes, yeah, I'm behind you, Mike.
So the one I see is heading into ghetto now.
Okay, you're ahead of me then.
Approaching the railway lines. Yes, that's turned left, the railway lines.
I just can't get there.
heading along the railway lines.
Cue the slow speed Benny Hill music.
Passing a car park.
I too have arrived in ghetto.
We're at the other end of the train lines now.
Yeah. I'm heading just triggering tech.
Along towards the.
Not go that way.
I don't see
anyone. It's a silly place.
Jeez, he's so far ahead of me. He's approaching the scrapyard though. No, he's turned left towards Square of Squares. I think.
How are you faster than me, Mike? What's going on?
I have skills.
Oh, burn.
Oh! That's a rather unfortunate cough.
And the crowd goes mild.
Whee!
I don't see him, but vaguely near Square of Squares.
Massive dump truck, mate. It shouldn't be that hard to pick up again.
16 Square of Squares, where dump trucks aren't really there.
Yeah, but he was so far ahead of me.
It's not a dump truck, right? It's a...
It's the thing we're driving.
Yeah, exactly. So, but the dump truck is a different one.
Oh, yeah. Interestingly, is that you? No, I haven't just overtaken you, Pete. I overtook a recycling van, like, it's Pete's colour.
So his was sort of slightly orangish.
Yeah, the sort of slightly rusty default colour.
Yeah.
Which is why when I colour my orange, it just looks the same.
There we go.
What a surprise, it's an oracle.
Inventive, Laurence. We love it.
We are so glad that you have the imagination to choose different cars. Yeah, but even so, it's covering both checkpoints right now. I think I might have him. Really janky driving, both sides. Yep, north side of shopping centre, heading west at speed, unless it's one of you is him. Getting to the edge of circle now, and circle has jumped. Yes, I have it.
So heading,
heading west from the north side of shopping centre towards low car parks. Turning left towards five ways. That crashed at a subway station. I've pitted him. No, I'm just keeping along. I'm heading towards Life Invader. Still heading towards Life Invader. Turning right up towards golf course, going clockwise around golf course. Still going clockwise around golf course. Turning left.
You're on the horizon.
Heading south from the north end of golf course. Now bearing southwest along small road. I have binned it slightly. Left turn. And then left turn again, temporary loss, regained. He appears to have slowed down to wait for me, which is kind of him. That one there, Pete, that you'd... you pitted me! Turn right just before the petrol station, going down small unnamed road. He's crashed again because he's good at driving. I don't even know where this is. Heading back towards golf course. Heading anti-clockwise around golf course on the east side? Towards five ways.
South
still side. Heading southeast. Passing Life Invader there.
We're all in line behind him.
Binned it. Been rammed. Approaching five ways. Let's be careful not to let him double end off.
He can go for the rare triple.
Going through shopping centre tunnel. Oh, that was unfortunate. I'm a little bit delayed.
He's just heading due east.
Is he doing his super tactical trick of driving in a very, very straight line right in front of us for as long as possible?
He turned south, lost sight of him. No, he's heading south towards Square of Squares. Turned right just before Square of Squares. May have turned left in lower, I'm not certain. I don't see him here though.
Just turn circle off.
wolf goes as Augustus. I found his car in lower, so let me know if your car changes.
Whereabouts in lower?
The car park, south.
Oh, I see. Like,
so he may be on foot around that area.
Yeah,
or seems likely.
Or he changed into another Orgrim.
Is this you, Tristan, running along now?
Yes, the one holding the gun. The guy with the great eye.
I will be very careful to run over everybody but you.
Is that someone else running up behind?
Where?
Grey suit.
Nope. We're all in car still.
Nope.
Okay.
Yes, someone under the tunnel. That. Is that?
Okay. Nice. Yeah. Why?
Voice those?
Is a different person who I was generally harassing. Yeah.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Laurence Plays, where we're continuing to play with silly, silly game modes. And we've still got the system set up where whenever I change cars, the hunters are put into identical cars. So they're all in MX-5s at the moment. And they're about to all be in they're all about to be in Inferni, because the Infernus is an entertainingly good car. So we'll use this for a change. Now, we are still playing fairly normal checkpoint rules. So I won't be able to take the checkpoint in this car. If we get into a chase, it's going to be very, very silly. I don't actually want to be using this car for the checkpoint approach, I don't think. Because obviously I won't be able to take the checkpoint in it. And there goes green. Let's try and go a different way and then try. Yeah, I really, really need to change cars. What's this? Oh, it's just some random 4x4 that'll do. Something not particularly good. Okay, so as soon as I take this, that means they will now all also be in BJXLs. Was that? I think that might be one of them, but oh no. Something weird happened behind me and I thought it might be one of the hunters, but it appears not to be. So, okay, let's carry on. So, yes, we've also we've changed another thing as well. So, in the last run, we decided that because the prey is really, really obvious, because he's in a specific model of car. Is purple going to see me as he goes past? Maybe. Yep, I think I've been made. I'm too close to that car in front of me. I'm getting out of here before he gets a glimpse of a good proper look at my character model. Okay, so we now have a lumbering 4x4 chase about to happen. Now, normally if I was in a 4x4 and I got into a chase, I go, okay, well, I'll try some off-road shenanigans, because the 4x4 might actually be better at that than the whatever cars the hunters are in. In this particular instance, they're in identical cars, though, so that's not going to work. So I'm just going to have to do normal fleeing tactics, whatever that might mean. Yes, so he's fading into the back, into the distance. Not the radio. Let's turn the lights off. That's what I wanted to do. Right, it's dark outside now, so hopefully it'll make me slightly harder to see. Ooh, that's a big slide. That's not how you take corners, Laurence. That said, he's hopefully going to have similar problems with the corner. He's probably not, because I just drove badly. So that was the fault of my driving, not the car. So we'll loop round here. Oh dear, there's I see some orange headlights. That'll be Mike. So now we've got two hunters in the vicinity. If I head back this way, so we'll head back. Oh, yep, yeah, there's two of them there. If we head back towards the and a third one as well. He's going for the intercept. Did he make it? No, but he didn't make it, but he also didn't take out any of the others, which is a shame. So we've made another change to the set settings as well. So the hunters don't know where the checkpoints are. They certainly don't have them on their maps. I am assuming that even when they drive through them, as we have been just now, they probably still don't get told. They don't see them. So the checkpoints are only known to me, which means, in a way, from the hunter's point of view, this is more like a survival run, in that they are just trying to track me by where the circle goes. Whereas for me, it's a checkpoint run. I have to get through the checkpoints. But this means they can't then try and guard the checkpoints. They just have to track me down. But it gives me something to do. Oh, that's bad. That's worse. So it gives me something to do, rather than just the trying to stay alive like I do in a survival run normally, which would make it a little bit more interesting, and make it a nice sort of amalgamation between the two. I've got a little bit of distance on him. The problem is, having a bit of distance is great, but it's going to be a struggle to get increase that distance because our cars are the same speed, same acceleration, same everything. And I can't do. And if he's further behind me like that, then I can't do ducking into a road at the last moment and hope he overshoots, because he'll get lots of warning because he's blooming miles behind. Oh, actually, he's caught up a bit, probably because I drove through some street furniture there. So this is going to be a tricky chase. I probably need to try and pull some sort of cunning shenanigan. You know, like the sort of thing I do on... Ooh, he's had a crash. Excellent. This might be... That might be it. I might be able to get away with that. As long as I don't have a crash as well. Let's turn the circle off. There we go. That gives me the opportunity to hopefully disappear into the city without them knowing exactly where I've gone. Yeah, that looks pretty good behind me. Okay. So I can now... on the anchors, round the corner here, and I'm going to head back south of the freeway again. Now, this is slightly cheeky because I know this is where the checkpoints are and they don't. So after I change cars, I'm going to give them a decent amount of time to get back down here, because otherwise it just wouldn't be fair. Ooh, that's an oracle. I could use an oracle. They're okay, and it's balanced because everyone's in them. But no, I'm going to use this Premier instead. Or is it a Primo? Something like that. Something beginning with P. Premier. There we go. Go on, get out. There. Right. So, they all now know that I've got away, I've changed cars, I've put the circle back on again, so they know roughly where I am. Now, I am really, really close to that west of Red Car Park checkpoint, so I'm not going to go and grab that, because that does seem a little bit... No, it doesn't seem a little bit unfair. It seems a lot unfair. So, what I think I'll do instead... is head over to the Square of Squares checkpoint reasonably quickly, and then I'll abandon this car, because I think they're going to mostly fixate on the model of car I'm driving rather than looking for pedestrians. I don't have much evidence to back this up, but it's a sort of a suspicion I have, because I think they're going to be so busy looking for other premieres that they're not going to be looking for pedestrians as much. That's my hope. I'm just going to again run this red light, because I think in this mode, just keeping moving is kind of important. Ooh, that's bad. One of them just passed me there. Let's pull up here behind this van. I don't know if AIs ever actually do this. Hop out of the car here and become a pedestrian. Right. So, phase one of plan complete. I think, I'm hoping that I've parked that car sensibly enough that they won't be suspicious of it. Now, the problem is, AI characters don't tend to cross roads. So I need to try and cross roads as quickly as possible when nobody's looking, or they're going to get very, very suspicious of me. Like so. I see no coloured... Oh, no, I see some purple headlights over there. Alright, let's continue down this road a bit. Is he coming this way? Yes. But he's gone past over that way. He's still going... Yep, I think he's out of sight now. Far enough away. I didn't look the other way before crossing the road, which is more than a little unwise. But... I think now I'm on the correct place to just walk up. Oh no, there's another couple of side roads along here, but there's the checkpoint. I don't know if they're going to have worked out... Ed's trying to change his character skin. I don't know if they've worked out that I'm going to be going for this checkpoint yet. And they probably have, because I was driving quite quickly across the city until now. And now I've suddenly started going slowly. And they'll know I'm going slowly because the circle isn't moving. So, I think they're probably going to guess that... I think they're going to guess that I'm going for the Square of Squares checkpoint and that I'm doing it on foot. So, I'm going to try and throw a spanner in the proverbials by getting into whatever the hell this is and then just going for it in a sort of more normal way. Let's see how this goes. And yeah, just running the red light because I don't like red lights. Was that that was the first checkpoint? Blimey, this is taking a long time. Shall I ditch this car? I think probably not. Let's stick with this for a bit longer. It's not going to be particularly great in a chase. But are you going to go? Yeah, it's not going to be particularly great in a chase, but then nor is whatever they're driving. So I think maybe my best bet, if I do get in another chase, maybe my best bet is to just keep going and keep going and keep going. Try to stay away from the hunters and just wait for them to make mistakes. And they'll be waiting for me to make mistakes as well, of course, because that's how mistakes work and how chases work. Okay, so checkpoint number two. I'm going to go for the ghetto church checkpoint. Because there's several checkpoints down in Ghetto. So if I head down that way, they're not going to know what I'm going for. Whereas if I go for the beach checkpoint, I think there's only one over in that sort of area. So as soon as they see me in that, in the sort of the Vespucci Canals area, they're going to know that I'm going for the beach checkpoint. And they're going to be able to hunt in almost exactly the right place. So I think this is probably the better tactic. What am I even driving at the moment? Oh, a Gresley. Okay. And normally I would say, this is a terrible, terrible vehicle. I don't want to be driving it because it'll make it really easy for the hunters to catch me. But because they're all driving the same things... Oh dear. Okay, that's bad because he's clearly spotted me. And I was in quite a distinctive vehicle. But he's clearly spotted me. And because I was... He approached me from the front. He's also going to see my character model. And somehow Mike has just spawned in out of nowhere. Okay, he's got out and he's going to start shooting. However, I think there's a decent chance that the bulletproof tyres on cars worse than coupes is probably still enabled. So I've probably got bulletproof tyres and I've got a big chunky 4x4 behind me. So I'm not going to say bulletproof because that sounds like hubris and just a good way to get myself killed. But I think they're probably going to struggle to do significant amounts of damage to me with their guns. I hope. We shall see. But now we've got another sort of... It's not quite an elephant race. We haven't gone for the big trucks. But it is very... Ooh, slidey. It's very much a one bad vehicle versus another one. So this is going to be quite a slow chase. We'll see how it goes. And other similar trying to turn cars around difficult corners noises. What if I go up here? Where does this go? Oh, this is the on ramp onto the freeway. Okay, so we'll go around here. It occurs to me that if they're communicating well enough and if they know the map well enough, they might be able to take a bit of a shortcut here, and that would be slightly unfortunate. So let's get over. Oh, big slides. Why is this such a slidey 4x4? Because it's a 3-ton vehicle or something probably. Let's turn the circle off while I try and get away, because I don't see anyone behind me at the moment. So if I now flee this way and take the emergency exit from the highway, like so, and smash into there like that. Nobody's behind me. Excellent. So let's turn the circle back on again. I haven't changed vehicles, which is a little bit brave of me. Ooh, is that the same? Yes, it is. Oh, okay. This is cunning. If I change from one Gresley into another Gresley... then they'll still be looking for a blue Gresley, and I'm in a black Gresley. Ooh, is this a 10,000 IQ moment? I'm not sure it really is, but I think this might be a sneaky thing to have done. Because they're going to be... Yeah, they're not going to have realised I've changed vehicle. So they're hopefully still going to be looking for that blue one I was in earlier. Ooh, if this works... I'm going to be really, really happy. So keep your eyes peeled for any more hunters, because they will be flying around this area at the moment. And I'm going to slow down a bit because I did turn the circle off, and therefore I don't want to take the checkpoint until I've had a decent chance to get to this sort of area. So if I drive up to the checkpoint and I haven't seen any hunters, maybe I'll go through it and come round again. and I haven't seen any yet. So I think, yeah, we'll do a loop around the block or something before I take this one. Maybe get a little bit closer to there. Ooh, it's gone. Yeah, it's gone green. Okay, so there's no hunters around. I'm not gonna wait until I actually see a hunter, but I am going to give them a bit of extra time to get into the area. And yeah, just because I left them all the way over in industrial. Now they might have seen roughly where I went, but even so, I think I should give them a bit of a chance to get over here. That was Mike. So I have now seen a hunter. Ooh, there's Tristan as well. So I've seen two hunters now. So I think I'm perfectly justified in heading back over to that checkpoint. And Mike didn't look twice. So I think the... they're all flying around near me, but not actually investigating me. I think they're all still looking for a blue grizzly. And I got away with that rather nicely. Oh, here comes Tristan. Oh, dear. Do AIs ever run over other AIs? I don't actually know. I think I've been spotted, though. That plan worked so nearly so well, but I don't know. I should have probably made a run for it slightly sooner and tried to take the and just taken the checkpoint without waiting quite so long for them to catch up and start harrying me. I don't know. I don't know whether I did it wrong there, or whether I just was being too nice to them, or whether that was just me being showing a sense of fair play. And oh no, that's a wall. Whether it was me showing a sense of fair play, which just sort of, yeah, because it would have been too hard for them otherwise. Oof, that was a big impact. Right, let's try and get out of here. So we've got another chase going. Good. What's my best bet here? My car appears to be slightly funny shape from where Pete pushed it into the wall. Mike is also a funny shape, and so is his car. Oh dear, I think I'm in trouble. Oh, thank you, Tristan. Aw, smacked right into it. Oh no, I did get him. Excellent. good. Okay, but there's still three of them behind me, and they can all tell Mike how to find me, where we're going, and all that sort of, and the circle's still turned on, because there doesn't seem to be much point in turning it off when there's three hunters right behind me, because they know where I am. They'll be able to tell Mike where I am without too much difficulty, so it shouldn't be hard for him to find me. And the circle is fairly approximate anyway, so it's probably the circle won't be giving him any more information than the other hunters are. I just need to do some kind of evasive slidey drive. What is that? That is not right. Oh dear, I'm driving badly and my car is beaten up. Oh, I should have gone for Tristan again. As well, rather. Apparently I'm doing a storm drain run. Who knew? Over the wall, there we go. Oh, it's jet skis. Oh, I got sniped. No.
Beach is the logical solution.
I buy a car that is, I don't mind that, wiggled a bit, which I thought he'd avoid doing. Nope, that's him.
Whereabouts?
Northwest of Beach Checkpoint, near Chinese Monument.
Far away.
Construction
site, going through Red Car Park checkpoint now. Turning east towards Red Car Park.
Oh, we don't have the blips, do we, for the checkpoints?
No.
That's annoying.
It's kind of the point. Going past lower now.
You're an asshole.
Oh,
nicely, I barely touched you. So again, turn right
turned
on.
Turned his lights off.
Oh, lights
turned
off.
Right at the far side of Square Squares.
Oh, this car.
Yeah, it's a bit rubbish, isn't it? Turned west again. Heading west side of Square Squares. We're approaching the southwest corner now. Turn left, so west, that car. Like.
Yep.
Heading west from Square of Squares. Passing Maze Bank. Pete's on your left. Oh, is that Mark? That car.
Yeah.
That's Mark.
Didn't get him.
It's all green. Passing red car park now, south side. Turning right after whatever that car park's called. Approaching Art Gallery. Turning east. Approaching red car park on the north side. Turning north. North from Dogleg. Approaching shopping centre. West side of shopping centre. Going up to the west side of shopping centre. Slowing down, going across the north side of shopping centre. He's crashed. Mikey's harassing him.
Oh, I've had an accident.
East along the north, north from the east side of shopping centre. And then west of the first road. Still going west. Approaching the edge of the circle. About to move it. He's moved it.
Now.
Still going west along that one. He's on the pavement. Sidewalk, because we're in America. Approaching golf course. Going anti-clockwise around golf course. Continuing anti-clockwise around golf course. Ah, car pulled out in front of me. Yes, that one. Pulled out in front of me. He's somewhere ahead of you, Pete.
He's continuing anti-clockwise. He's in the distance now. Turn the circle off. I did not see which way he turned.
Pick one.
I'll go straight.
I'll go right.
I'll go left.
It's not left.
I don't think it was straight.
Nothing obvious right. Although there are multiple ways you could have turned from here. Either that or he's just looking for another car. She does have a habit of slowing right down and then going, not that one, not that one, not that one. Which he does, he's just come out of a chase knowing we're 2 seconds behind him, will then just slow down to a normal speed like, point we No. I was gonna be too harsh. As long as you remember I'm purple, Pete, it's fine.
I've got him, I think.
Purple every time you see him.
I've got him higher, lower, blue car, he's fleeing.
Oh, I'm literally right behind you.
Direction?
Yep. Heading west. Arcadia, yep. Hispanic male, dark hair, I think like a grey greeny type shirt.
I think I got a tyre. Maybe wrong.
I'll let you know.
Heading back towards Square Squares. North side, mid bank.
Correct. Heading east now. Continuing east. On Square Squares now. Continuing east. Heading to the bridge. Over the bridge. He's doing his amazing tactic of driving a straight line.
I mean,
it's the way
that
he genuinely
cars,
gets.
So.
Yeah, it's the way he genuinely expects to lose is by driving in a straight.
Right, taking a right, so heading south now. Parallel to the highway.
I've accidentally jumped onto the highway by using, as a jump, the lamppost that I think was end knocked over.
Sorry.
So left now. And another left again, stand by the big storage building. I've lost him. Well, on earth did he go? He didn't go around the thing, did he? Yes, he did. So we're going around the swirly thing onto the highway.
Good. Which bit of the highway? Because I'm on the highway.
I'll let you know when I get there. He may have jumped off. I didn't see him. Did he jump off?
So he jumps off.
I've kind of lost him in the highway spaghetti. Sorry, I'm being really mean this evening. I do apologise.
In fairness, so am I. I'm I've had a pretty stressful day, and I'm not venting so much. Just yeah.
Being you sassy. Are a collective punchbag.
Yeah.
Sad head noises.
I have a car in the ghetto driving erratically. It may be one of you.
I found
it also
one
may
earlier.
Not.
It was green. Green
undercar. Yeah. If this is one of you, this is definitely a player. Am I behind somebody?
Yes, that's me.
The lime green?
Okay, no, it's fine. I found it. Good, it's good.
Hang on.
It does not appear to be a Latino male. That appears to be a female with a gun.
Yep, so Pete got out and tried to shoot me.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it is Mike, so justified.
Yeah, it's
found him, behind you, right?
Behind me,
Ed.
Ring of fire. Oh, hello. Yeah, black one, I'm with you.
Yeah, heading out towards Square of Squares.
Yeah. Heading north.
East side of Square of Squares.
Circle jump,
Yeah.
That's double circle jump, which is why I said
definitely him.
Okay.
Heading towards Pillbox Hill Hospital.
Yep.
Left into the tunnel. Mind the car, Tristan.
He hit the car. Well,
so. Yeah, I've got him.
Whereabouts?
Through the tunnel.
Outside of the tunnel, heading up
he's
the ramp.
Slowed down a lot.
Towards Arcadius.
South.
He didn't really have a choice, there was two trucks coming against traffic. I tried to push him into them.
Hit him.
Nice!
Driving south,
and
right?
Yeah. Bend.
It's alright.
Nah, never mind.
I slammed
it was almost
brakes.
Beautiful.
Oh. It's worth a try.
At least he got the credit.
An amazing death.
Otherwise, one of us would be out as well.
Who that?
Heading towards ghetto. Heading into ghetto now. This is towards Arena, I believe.
Yes.
Correct.
The thing is, I don't need to worry about what card hijack as long as I get a card.
Yes.
Continuing clockwise.
Towards heliport.
Yeah. He's going to go off road? No, he's not. He's following the road. That's very nice.
I'm getting out.
Where is he?
Heliport.
Heliport.
Okay. Heading north?
No, south.
He's crashing into the storm drain.
Storm run heading.
Oh, nice one.
I am amazed at that shot, actually.
Yeah.
What?
I was not expecting
that's outrageous.
Was
it outrageous?
I was going for a tire. Yeah, I'm still on the road.